The key to solving problems like this is to figure out how does the address break down into offset, index, and tag bits. Conflicts will occur where different blocks have the same index bits. In this particular cache, 256 byte block size means that there are 8 bits to the block offset. In hex, conveniently, that means that the least significant 2 digits are the offset, and we can safely ignore those because they're not part of the index. Now we need to figure out how many bits are in the index. We have 16 kilobytes and 256 byte blocks. The number of blocks in the cache is this divided by this, and that gives us 64 blocks. 64 is 2 to the 6th, so we need the next 6 bits here to tell us what the index is. The 6 bits will be contained in the next 2 hex digits, so for 56 hex, we can write it out as binary. This is 5, this is 6, and we are interested in these bits here. So we're really looking for which blocks of these have the same bits here. Those that have 56 definitely will have the same index bits. So we will definitely have a conflict here and here, possibly. But in order to actually have a conflict, it needs to be a different block. This address here does not conflict with this one here because they're actually in the same block. They have the same block number. So this is not a conflict. They do map to the same place in the cache, but they're actually the same block, so it's not a conflict among blocks. This, however, is a different block number that definitely maps to the same index, so this is a conflict. 5-5 looks like this. These are the 6 bits. They're not the same, so this block will not conflict with the one here. Finally, 1-6 looks like this. These are the bits that we're interested in, and they do indeed match the ones of this block, so this goes to the same place in the cache as this, and it's a different block because this is 1-2-3-4-1-6 and this is 1-2-3-4-5-6, so this will also conflict with our block.